How you doing, everyone? Scott here. Finally back after I think about four or five weeks off doing videos. It was the same as last year. This time of year is just absolutely manic for me, so I don't get much time to make videos, and if I do have time, I'm absolutely knackered and I'm basically getting in from work, having my tea, and then going to my bed because I just don't get a day off. So glad to finally be sitting back down again and doing a video. Over the month I've accumulated a lot of stuff, so forgive me if I don't go into like massive amount of detail on some of these albums or pickups, but there's just a lot to get through, and I'm going to try and keep this video short, shorter than 45 minutes. So I'm just going to dive straight in. And I got a message from Cloudy Milder, Andy, and he'd noticed on Amazon that the price of this album had dropped significantly in price, and it's not really an album that I was really looking for because I do have like the deluxe CD version, but at that price, I think it was like under £13 or something like that, I wasn't passing it up. And it's Iron Maiden's live chapter on the Book of Souls tour. Andy has actually showed this because he picked it up for himself as a Christmas present, basically. But yeah, I jumped on it as well. It is the three disc set, and it's basically just live tracks taken from the Book of Souls tour. I'm sure you've all seen it before, so I'm not going to go into massive amount of detail. But yeah, at that price, I was not turning it down. So that is the Iron Maiden live chapter. Next up is a new release this year, and it is the second album from Burning Witches. I'm sure their debut album only came out, I want to say it was this year as well, in February, but their debut is absolutely immense. So when I saw this coming out, it's Hexenhammer. When I saw this coming out, I was all over it, and it didn't disappoint. I would say the first album does tip this one, but that's not to say it's not a good album, because it's absolutely great. Some really great songs in here. Don't Cry My Tears is one of the ballads on this album, and if you've not heard Burning Witches, they are like a female version of Judas Priest, just awesome. And they do a really good version of Holy Diver as well. They could have mixed it up a little bit for doing a cover of Dio, because there has been a lot of covers of that song, and it does kind of like stick to the same template throughout the song, but still good cover nonetheless. And this is the gatefold as well. So that is Burning Witches. Check them out if you haven't. Really awesome stuff. These ones I've had for a while just lying around, and this one I was really glad to get. I got these, the next two together, off the same seller on Facebook, and it is Arch and Another Return. I've been looking for this album for a while, but it does get a bit pricey from some sellers, so I've kind of like kind of backed off from a few of them. But the guy who was selling this was not wanting a lot of money for it, and it is in really good condition, so really happy to pick that up. And the next one I got off him was Alice Cooper and Hey Stupid from, I think this is 1991. Yeah, 1991 on Epic. One of Alice Cooper's great albums, I think. I mean, people do prefer the original stuff, the 70s stuff, and then like the 80s stuff as well. I love the 80s stuff, but this is a really, really solid album as well, and shouldn't be overlooked. So that is that one. Now, what I'll do is actually I'll flip onto some CDs and some cassettes. I don't know why I've done it in this order, but I'm losing my mind. Anyway, I picked up these two cassettes yesterday, Mr. Big and Lean Into It. I'm not a massive tape collector, but I just picked these up. I think this was like £1.99, so picked that up. And I also picked up Lita Ford. So just wee cheap tapes that I picked up. In fact, I'll do the CDs and stuff at the end. I don't know why I'm doing it in this order, who knows. Next up is two I got in today from the same seller, and the first one is from Jet Red, and this is from 1989. This is our self-titled album. I think they only have two albums. I might be wrong. Yeah, this is just really good melodic hard rock. A bit along the lines of kind of like Steelheart. I mean, the drummer I think is from Steelheart. So yeah, just really good melodic rock. And this is on Music for Nations. Inside you do get the insert. So really happy to pick that up, and I picked it up for next to nothing as well. So I was all over it, Jet Red. And the next one is the debut from Kix, self-titled from 81. Not checked this either. Yeah, 1981. I've not actually heard a lot of this album, so I'm looking forward to giving this a spin in the next couple of days. So I don't think this comes with anything really that quite boring inside. But yeah, Kix debut, really good stuff. Well, I hope it's good stuff. I've not actually heard the whole album yet. So the next ones, in fact, I'll do this one first. So if you follow me on Facebook, the Rock Scout page on Facebook, which if you don't, I'll leave a link below, and you can always like my Facebook page. I picked up a reissue this year, and it was through Amazon, and Amazon basically buggered up the order twice and gave me the right album, but it was a picture disc and not the standard black vinyl version. So that album is Thundersteel by Riot, which is just an awesome album. I was spinning it the other night, and I couldn't find myself to do anything else. I just wanted to sit and just listen to it because it's that good. It's just amazing. It's a perfect album. Absolutely awesome. So instead of getting this first time round, I got this. I got the picture disc. So I mean, it's still the same album, but I really just wanted the standard black edition. So I did complain, and then they sent me another one. So yeah, I think I've got my fill of Riot this month. But in the end, I just made a massive fuss about it, and I said it's for my brother's birthday. I don't even have a brother. And they just said, look, just keep the records. So I've got three. But anyway, really good album. Three editions, awesome. And the next one I picked up yesterday in a dig, and it's Brittany Fox and their second album, Boys in Heat. I do have the first Brittany Fox, and I was going to pick this up. I think this was like $4.99, and I was just like, yeah. I'm all over that. This comes in insert, lyrics and band photos as well. I think this is from 1989. Yeah, 1989. And I would say it is a step up from their debut as well, so really happy to pick that one up. Right, now we're on to my big haul of yesterday. I mean, this was kind of the start of the big haul yesterday, but these ones coming up. I took a wee trip out yesterday. I haven't been digging for weeks and weeks and weeks, and there is a shop that a fellow VCer Cloudy Milder goes to. We obviously live in the same city, but his kind of local record shop is quite not far away, but it's a bit of a pain to get to because it's through the city centre and all this kind of stuff. So I've kind of got record shops at my side, he's got his record shops at his side, so there's a bit of a turf war between us. But I just don't get the chance to really go out there that often. So what I did yesterday, I just made a point, I need to get to this place. And they had said to me, you've got to get to Vinyl Villains, it's really good. So went down there and gave it a shot, and I picked up some really great stuff. I was really pleased with what I picked up. I did make a joke with Andy that I was kind of on his turf, but I reckon the things I've picked up he wouldn't really be interested in or already had, so I didn't feel too guilty in the end. So what I did pick up is first one was Black and Blue, Nasty Nasty. This is their second album from 1986. Is it our second album? I think it is our second album. maybe their third album. I'm not sure, you can correct me. I'm going to say second. No, I say second. Doesn't matter. Anyway, Black and Blue, Nasty Nasty, does nothing to see there. It does feature Tommy Thayer from the recent lineup of Kiss, and is also produced by Gene Simmons. So, kind of like second tier hard rock hair metal. But nonetheless, I'm really happy to listen to this kind of stuff. I love it. So, that is Black and Blue, Nasty Nasty. Don't think you'd be after that, Andy. Next up is an EP, and it's from David Lee Roth, his debut EP, Crazy in the Heat. Crazy from the Heat, sorry. Basically just four tracks, four cover tracks. You've got Easy Street, Just a Gigolo, I think that's kind of like a medley. California Girls and Coconut Grove. So this was priced at $2.99, so I was definitely going to pick that up. That is David Lee Roth. Next up is Deep Purple and Perfect Stranger. I've just recently picked this up on CD, just kind of finding my feet with Deep Purple. But it was Perfect Stranger I heard on the rock radio that I usually listen to. Loved the song, checked out the album, and I thought it was awesome. So I was straight out to buy the CD, and I've been looking for a decent version on vinyl, so finally got that. And comes in this really nice kind of hard stock inner. So that's me starting my vinyl Deep Purple journey. Next up is an album that I would say every hard rock metal fan has. It's considered to be one of the best debuts ever. And I have this on CD. I've had it a couple of times on CD because I wore it out. I have got the reissue on vinyl, but I've never had this version. And it is Guns N' Roses, Appetite for Destruction, with the band cover. I've just never had it. I've never had this this version of it. And with this version, people just want, I don't know why, they want absolutely just stupid money for it. So picked this up in Andy's local store, and it was just a decent price, so I couldn't go wrong with it. Inside, it does come on the red vinyl as well. So yeah, really happy to pick that up. It's something that I didn't really need, but I knew I was going to pick up anyway, so I was all over it. So that is Guns N' Roses, Appetite for Destruction. Right, next up. Will I do that one next? I'll go with this one next. Next one is the second album from Bonfire, and it's Point Blank. As you can see from the cover, it has been signed. I wasn't too sure about the signatures. It wasn't, the price of the record wasn't based on it having autographs, so it wasn't super expensive or anything. But I have kind of checked it out a wee bit online, and they do seem to be legit. And I have seen a few of these kicking about. This is actually the second signed version of this I have seen, but this version that I bought was more than half price of the one I saw before. So I think this is maybe the third version I've seen. There's one, I'm sure I saw one on the VC, somebody showed it. So I don't know if it was a, they obviously did like a signing in the UK or something like that. But if you've not checked out Bonfire, they're just amazing. I'm really looking to pick up their debut. This is their second album. Fireworks is their third album, which is just absolutely insanely good. But I think that's probably as far as I go. I do have the album Knockout, but it's just so below par compared to these ones. I would definitely stick with the first three, but the first three are just insane. Really, really good stuff. Amazing melodic hard rock. So that is Bonfire and Point Blank. Next one is, this is actually a recommendation that I've seen a few times from Metal Mickey. He just always pulls me out of the bag, really. And he's mentioned this album a couple of times. He's mentioned the band a few times, and every time he mentions this album, I always go and listen to it. And I've just never had like a physical copy of it, but I'll go on YouTube and I'll listen to the album and think, I need to pick this up. I have searched for it a couple of times on eBay, but it's kind of few and far between, and it's just never really happened. But in Andy's local shop, and this just popped straight out at me for under a tenner, and it's Mordred and Fool's Game from 1989. This is their debut, I believe. Really awesome stuff. I would probably mix it between. I had it in my mind yesterday. I had this on yesterday, and I thought that is just. It was Megadeth mixed with somebody else, and Megadeth kind of mixed with Faith No More. It's kind of got that kind of, I would say Megadeth kind of melody and vocal, but with like a kind of funk, kind of funk thrash, a bit like kind of Faith No More. It's hard to explain, but if that sounds good to you, pick up this album because that's what it's like. But yeah, Mordred the Fool's Game, really good stuff. And like I said, every time Mike mentioned it, I was always on because it just reminded me that it was a good album. I wanted to listen to it. So, and it also came with the merch sheet, which has like creator vests, Halloween, Running Wild, Voivod, Tankard, Sabbath, like seeing all that kind of stuff. And it also came with the inner with lyrics and promotional stuff on the back, so really happy to pick that up. It's in really good condition, so yeah, as soon as I saw that, it was in the buy pile. If I can get this back in, so yeah, Mordred Fool's Game from 1989, check it out, awesome. Right, I'll do these three next. These were all actually a mix from different shops, but picked up Whitesnake, Come and Get It. From 1981, I think. Slide It In from 1984. And I know, Cloudy, you wouldn't be picking these up. I don't think you're a massive Whitesnake fan. But Slide It In, I love this album. You've got Slide It In, I love that. The title track, Slow and Easy, is an absolutely great song as well. So, really happy to pick that one up. And I also picked up Slip of the Tongue. Now, I do have this on CD. I'm really not sure if I've got this on vinyl. It's one of those ones. But yeah, you've got Fool for Your Lovin', Now You're Gone, Judgment Day, absolutely great song in that. So I don't know what this is. I think that's kind of Bleach Marks, but it wasn't overly pricey, so I wasn't really too fussed. So yeah, that was kind of my Whitesnake kick for the day. Always looking for more Whitesnake because it's something I really don't have a lot of on vinyl, so that is that. And the last vinyl I'm going to show was. Muggle. It's an album that I probably don't like as much as other people, but it's an album that I would never turn down. Whether coming across it, I have looked for it before. I would say people think this album is really, really great, and I think it's good. So it's worth having in the collection, but I just don't think I give it as much love as other people. So, but I was still all over it when I saw it, and it is Badlands from, I think this is the 90s, 91 or something. Oh, 89, 1989. So. Badlands featuring Ray Gillen and Jake E. Lee. Who else is on this? Can't remember now. Oh, is it Eric Singer? Thinking like Eric Singer. Yeah, Eric Singer on drums. Jake E. Lee on guitars and Ray Gillen on vocals. So yeah, it's one of those albums that I see it gets a lot of love in the VC. But sorry, I'll show you that. Badlands. It gets a lot of love, but it's just, I don't know, it just doesn't seem to click with me as much as it does with other people. But for the price it was, it wasn't getting left behind anyway, so I'm happy to pick that one up because I know it's not an easy find. So that is that one. So that's the vinyl. A quick load of CDs I picked up. Picked up the new Metal Church, Damned If You Do. I'm going to be honest, the CDs I've not really given much attention to, due to just like having no time to really do anything. So yeah, I've only heard the singles that have been released from this, that have been released on YouTube. So but what I've heard has been absolutely amazing. So I thought I'd pick that up. I just thought I'd pick up a CD. I think I might be getting it on vinyl. It's my birthday soon. So also picked up Manowar, Louder Than Hell. Always a good cheap find in HMV before it goes down the pan. Next up is the debut from Flotsam and Jetsam, Doomsday for the Deceiver, the only one to feature Jason Newsted. So happy to pick that one up. I picked up the brand new album from Skullfist, Way of the Road. If you're a Skullfist fan, this I don't think kind of lives up to their first two. I love the first two. It still has that kind of like the Skullfist sound, but it's really, I think it really kind of just lacks something. It sounds really light, like the production, like production wise, it sounds really light. It sounds quite tinny. It seems to like lack some bass, and I don't know. I've only listened to it a couple of times, so it might take me a wee while to kind of click into it. But yeah, I would say out of the first three, this is kind of on the lower end of the scale. But I'll have to give it a few more listens anyway. So that is a Skullfist and Way of the Road. Next up, I've got the new Accept, Symphonic Terror. This is basically their live set from Wacken in 2017. It is a fold-out digipack. So yeah, you've got CD1 is just part one is Accept, just Accept on their own, and then you've got part two, which is Headbanger Symphony, which is Wolf Hoffman's kind of side project, his solo project, and then you've got CD2 and part three, which is Accept with the orchestra. So, and then you get all the classics on there, like Balls to the Wall, Metal Heart and all that kind of stuff. So I thought it was a really good pickup. I actually thought this was a DVD as well, but happy with the three set CD anyway. So that is that. And the last one, the last CD I picked up was Kings Among Scotland, the live album from Anthrax. I was looking to pick up the vinyl box set, but Cloudy Milder did a wee review on it and said it wasn't the best for, and it just kind of wasn't laid out properly, and he said you'd probably be better just with the CD. So that's what I did, I just went with the CD, and it sounds awesome. Joey Belladonna is still insanely good. They just sound amazing live, and I wasn't going to not pick up Kings Among Scotland, as it was recorded in Scotland. So yeah, but it just adds to it that it just sounds awesome. So they are the CDs. And last of all, I just picked up this book. This was a really cheap book out of HMV. I just thought I'd pick it up for the sake of it, but it's actually quite funny. It's called The History of Heavy Metal, and it goes through all different genres, like the first wave of black metal, the golden age of heavy metal. It just goes through a whole part of Black Sabbath, let's see, thrash metal, a chapter called Glam Fucking Metal, or Fucking Glam Fucking Metal. The guy who basically wrote this book is a massive death metal fan and hates everything about glam and hair metal. So that chapter's quite funny. But yeah, just a wee cheap pickup. I thought I would just add into the book collection. So right, that's me done. So everyone have a good new year. Let me know what you think of my pickups. Hopefully I'll be back in my regular rhythm in the new year, and I will see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.